And we're off. Okay, this is Legoland. It's about a place where dreams come true. If you can't afford to travel, but you still want satisfaction, you can see in miniature all the world's great tourist attractions. At Legoland. 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 The model of Big Ben alone is worth the price it costs to enter. We've even got a pile of Lego that used to be the World Trade Center, Legoland. That's right, people, I'm telling you, there is a place where dreams can come true, a place of wonder, a place of wow, and it's way out west, near Slough, and it's called, and I want you to sing it with me. This next number is a garage rock or garage rock, whatever you want to call it, about a member of the royal family. I find that the royal family is extremely inspirational for me in the genre of punk rock music. Basically, all the punk rock songs I've ever written have been themed on a particular member of the royal family. Yeah, I guess Johnny Rotten kicked it off with God Save the Queen and that kept the tradition going. So here we go. This is about Prince Charles. It's called Chinless Wonder.
A chinless wonder was born into a house full of scone. And right into the gin was his next of kin, so come on. And by the time he's king, came on only a thing. He'll have to sell off the lease without getting the lease for some more. Man, wrong man, sad wrong man, man sensitive son. Too much time spent flushing the rent instead of sitting up on the throne. On the throne. On the throne, on the throne, on the throne. Too much time spent flushing the rain. It's just a sin and I'm on the throne.
here's another one I'm gonna do.
I might be wearing no clothes.
It's about nudism.
I might be quite indisposed. And everything I propose is a no-go, a no-go, a no-go. But the things I say down at the local K&J and the bills I pay won't be coming back today. Oh yeah, I'd like to take you back home, back to where I was born, between the sheets and my comb. I was born, but the bills I pay down at the local K&J and the sins I pay won't be coming back today. Yeah,
okay, that's a nice little number. Right. Next one is called Leg Warmers and Leopard Skin Briefs, which is the attire that I'm wearing right now. But to see the bottom half of this video image, you should have to subscribe and pay me money. Because that's how it works, you pervert.
I had a girl, she loved me. But I told that girl she had to be. She criticized when I wore my leg warmers and leopard skin briefs. You don't like it, baby, hit the road. They help me emphasize my genitals. Leg warmers and a leopard skin briefs sure look good on. Gets my stroll on. Sure looks good on.
Let's go!
You don't like it, baby, hit the road. They help me emphasize my genitals. Leg warmers and leopard skin briefs. Sure look good on.
Cross-dressing never hurt anybody. This song is about United Kingdom comedy scene, which I was a part of, until I found out that I was no longer making money in that particular scene. Not that I ever had. I'm gonna have to edit this bit out because I can't think of anything funny to say about it, but it's kind of my experience in that particular milieu.
It was great to be a comic on the UK comedy scene. Each day was filled with glamour. living in that show business dream. I played Romford and Crawley and Didcot and Horley and even Tunbridge Wells. Though I admit, when I first started, I played the smaller towns as well. I was rude to a heckler in Didcot. Didn't realize he had special needs. So in the break to compensate, I bought him a lager, in which I secretly peed. I was attacked by an audience in Biggleswade. They accused me of being sarky. I remember these tattooed hands beating me up. Man, that was one rough hen party. I'd like to thank my agent, who's responsible for how far I've come. Though I wish she didn't charge 95%, but how do you fire your mum? Fire your mum.
Thank you. That came off quite well. I think I'm going to go masturbate now to celebrate. Not on scale, not on, you know, that is definitely paid for you. Paid for you. I'm sorry, I'm masturbating right now. I'm a bit confused. But I do not with my hands, with my one foot. I learned it from a swami. It's quite a... That's why they're all standing on one leg. You didn't know that, did you? That's what they're up to. Well, you got to do what you got to do when you're in your 70s.